Hi, I'm Mo Vizzy Beady. Today I'm going to show you how to make this pendant. I think it's intermediate to advanced tutorial. You certainly need a knowledge of beading before you give it a go. If you are a beginner, then by all means, if you're feeling brave, yep, go for it. I'll try my best to answer any questions you may have. You can play around with the colours. I've used blues. I do like blues, I just think they're pretty. Let's just get going then. For this pendant I'm using colour 1, you need 24 super duos. These are turquoise blue. You need 30 of your colour 2. These are jet blue iris. 18 4mm bicones. These are pale blue by Swarovski. 15 aught seed beads, they're galvanised silver by Mayuki. 11 aught seed beads, they're also galvanised silver by Mayuki. A 12mm Rivoli, it's aqua, I think it's aqua, by Mayuki. By Swarovski. I'm using a bale on this particular pendant. Tools, you need a size 12 beading needle. The thread, I am using Fireline by Beadlon, and it's 0.006 inch diameter. You need 2 arm spans of thread onto your needle. You need a pair of scissors to cut your thread and a pair of pliers for the tight spots. To begin with, you need 12 of your colour 1 super duos. It's a good idea at this point to check that all your holes are clear, because it's painful finding out that one's blocked when you've nearly finished. So I've got 12 and I'm going to thread all them onto my needle. So that's what we've got. We've got 12 super duos. Take them down to the end of your thread. Only leave a short tail because you don't need a long one. And I'm going to tie a knot. The first knot, don't tie it tight because we need a bit of movement in this loop. So 2 knots. And then your third knot. Pull that one fairly tight. So my thread's coming in between these two beads here, and I'm going to go through 3 of the same holes that I've gone through, just to move my knot away from the end of my thread. So if you just hold on to your work and pull your thread through, your knot will slip through. And then I'm going to go all the way around these beads one more time to secure my work. Set up with my tail there, so I know I need to go through at least 3 more beads to do my full circle. So there's my 3. I'm just going to go through another 2. Make sure you try and get your tail out of the way. We're going to get rid of that in a second. So through another two, and then I know it's gone round a total of at least twice. So now I'm going to cut my tail off, and that's what I have so far. I'm coming out of the bottom hole of this super duo. I'm going to step up by going through the same hole, same super duo, but in a different direction. And now I need to turn my work around so I can work in the direction that's good for me. So I'm going around here now. Get the rest of your colour one super duos. I'm going to put one in between each of these pairs of super duos. So pick up a super duo and go through the next top hole of the next super duo. Again, the super duo through the top hole of the next super duo. Do this all the way around until you've got back to the beginning. See, I've missed one there, look. So I'm just going to have to back up. Background. Wasn't concentrating. And the last one, go through the last super duo and through the bottom hole of the first super duo we added in this round, and that's what we have. Now we need to step up by going into the same super duo of the next hole up for the top hole. Now we're going to add our colour two, one in between each of these pairs of super duos. So I'm going to turn my work over, pick up the next colour and go through the top hole of the next super duo. So we're adding our last one, and I'm going to go through the next super duos, because again I'm going to go right round these to secure my work. And now I'm going to step up again. I'm coming out of the colour 2 super duo at the bottom hole, so I need to go back on myself and back into the top hole. Now in between each of these super duos I'm going to pop a 15-aught seed bead. Don't worry about pulling these tight yet, because we're going to pop our Rivoli in there soon. So just pop them in there all the way around. Our last one. I'm going to go into the super duo, through the 15 and through the super duo. And this is what we have. You see it's loose. Right, now we need to try and pop our Rivoli in there. If you pull it tight you'll see that it cups it. Okay, but when you let go it just pops open again. So this is another fiddly bit. So pull it tight, you need to pull it in the direction of the circle, not away from, not out, but down. And then wrap it around your finger and then hold it down here, but it's a bit slippery with it being nylon. And then just keep doing this until you've gone around a few times and eventually it will stop popping open. Just keep going round and round these beads, pulling each time. at it. It's still popping open at the moment. Every time I pull it tight, you can't see it much, but you can feel it. In fact, if I pop it down and let it go, it springs out a bit. We'll just keep going. With it being Fairline, it's a bit slippery. Doesn't seem to grip on itself. I can feel the holes are getting a bit tighter now, so it'll start to hold on to itself now. I'm just going to try and go through another couple. I don't want to risk snapping my thread or breaking a bead. So I'm coming out of a super duo that we added on the round before last. I'm going to go back through the whole of the same super duo. So I'm stepping down because I'm going into the middle. And ideally I need to go through the whole of the super duo that's next to it as well. Right. Take some patience, but I've got there. So I've come out of the top hole of this super duo, I'm going into the bottom hole of the same super duo and through the next hole of the next super duo of colour 1 that we added in the middle round. And that's where we need to be now. This is what we have so far. That's the front and that's the back. Now I'm going to pick up 3 11-aught seed beads. I'm coming out of this super duo and I'm going to go through the next super duo of the same colour through the same hole that we're coming out of, you know, the top hole. And that's what we've got. Now we need a 11, a super duo of colour 2 and 11. And go through the blue again, that you know, colour 1. Pick up 3 11-aught seed beads and go through the blue colour 1 again. Try and be as careful as you can not to break any of your beads. Pick up an 11, a super duo of colour 2 and an 11. Go through the next hole. Straighten the needle out a bit. Pick up 3 11-aught seed beads and go through the next colour 1 super duo. Pick up an 11, a super duo of colour 2 and an 11. Go through the next colour 1. Pick up 3 11s. and go through the next colour one. Pick up an 11, a super duo, and an 11. Go through the next colour one. Pick up 3 11s. Go through the next colour one. Pick up an 11, super duo, and an 11. And go through the next colour one. Pick up 3 11s, go through the next colour one. And now we're on our last one. So we need an 11, a super duo, and an 11. And we're going to go through the next colour one. Doesn't matter if you come out of the back or the front, doesn't matter, whichever's easiest. And now I'm going to step up by going through the first two of the 3 super duos we added on this round. So I'm now coming out of the middle of the 3 11 aught C beads. Right, for the next round, we're going to start adding our bicones. When you're next to a seed bead, when you're coming out of a seed bead, you need a bicone. And when you go to a super duo, you're going to put a super duo next to it. So because we're coming out of an 11, we're picking up the bicone first, and then the super duo, and we're going through the top hole, the super duo. So we're coming out of a super duo, so we need a super duo, and then the bicone. And then we're going to go into the middle hole, sorry, the middle bead of the 3 we added on the last round. And because we're coming out of an 11, we need a bicone and then a super duo. And I'm going to go into the top hole of the next super duo. Pick up a super duo and a bicone and go through the middle of the 3 11s. Pick up a bicone and a super duo and go through the top hole of the super duo we added in the last round. Pick up a super duo and a formal bicone and go through the middle bead of the 3 we added earlier. Pick up a bicone and then a super duo and go through the super duo. Pick up a super duo and then a bicone and into the middle bead of the 3 we added earlier. Bicone, super duo, top hole of the super duo, super duo, bicone through the middle bead. Bicone, super duo, through the super duo. And your last super duo and your last bicone on this round. And go through the middle bead again, the one we were coming out of when we started this round. Give that a gentle pull, unless you want to just work your way around and tighten it up as you go around. Now we're going to pop up through the first bicone that we added of the last round, and I'm going to go through the bottom hole of this super duo, the top hole of that one, and the bottom hole of this one, because we need to be at this side of the Super Duos. So this is what we have so far. It's a good idea to check your work now. Make sure you've got three super duos next to each other and two bicones next to each other all the way around. So we're coming out of the bottom hole of this super duo. Now we need to pick up three 15-aught seed beads and we're going to go back into the top hole of the same super duo. Pick up your 4mm bicone and go into the top hole of the next super duo. Pick up three 15-aught seed beads. I'm going to go into the bottom hole of the same super duo that we're coming out of. Just that one, not all three, just the one. And now we need a 15-aught and 11 and a 15, and we're going to skip the middle super duo and go through the bottom hole of the next super duo, and if it lets you, go down the 4mm. If not, do this in two steps. Just make sure that needs a little pop up, so it's like a little pico, so it just sits like that. Give that a gentle pull. Pick up a 15-aught seed bead and go up the next 4mm bicone, and again we need to be at the other side of these three super duos. So we're just working our way across the next to the other side. And once we're at the other side, we're just going to repeat the process that we've just done on this one. So we need three 15-aught seed beads and into the top hole of the super duo. Pick up your 4mm bicone and go into the top hole of the next super duo. Then pick up three 15-aught seed beads and into the bottom hole of the super duo. Just that one, not all three. Now we need a 15. An 11 and a 15. I'm going to skip the middle super duo and go into the next one, and then if it lets you, down the 4mm bicone. Just make sure that sits nice, and a gentle pull. Pick up a 15-aught seed bead and then go back up the bicone, and we're working our way to the other side of these three super duos. Can start to get a bit tight at some points. You've just got to be really patient with it and gentle. There we go. There we go. So we're at the other side now. So again, we pick up three 15-aught seed beads and go into the top hole of the super duo that we're coming out of. Pick up your bicone and into the top hole of the next super duo. Pick up three 15-aught seed beads and into the bottom hole of the super duo that you're coming out of. Excuse me. Pick up your 15, an 11 and a 15. skip the middle super duo and into the next one and down the 4 millimeter like I'll make sure that sits right. So pick up your 15 and back up the next pick up your next 15 and go up the next bicone and to the other side of them three super duos. Like that. So we need our 3 15s again, back into the top hole of the super duo that you're coming out of. Pick up your 4 millimeter and into the top hole of the next super duo. Pick up 3 15s and into the bottom hole of the super duo. Pick up a 15, an 11, and a 15. Skip the middle one and into the next one. And if you can, down the 4 millimeter bicone. Pick up a 15 and up the next bicone. And again, when we're going to make our way to the other side of these three super duos. Three 15s into the top hole of the super duo that you're coming out from. Sometimes you just need these to persuade these that where you want them to sit. Pick up your 4 millimeter and into the next super duo. 3 15s and into the bottom hole of the next super duo. One 15, one 11, and one 15. Skip the middle super duo and into the next one, and if you can, down the 4 millimeter. Just persuade that to sit correct. Pick up a 15 and then up the next bicone and again the other side of these three super duos. This is your last one and it sometimes does get a bit tight. So you've just got to be really patient and possibly your pliers might be useful. Just try your best not to break your beads. I think I've got a bit of a bend in my needle, doesn't help. Made it. Oh, I've definitely got a bend in my needle. Right, so now 3/15. And into the top out of your Super Duo. Pick up your 4mm biker. And into the top out of your other Super Duo. And 3/15 and into this tight hole. Oh no, that one's easy. 1/15, 1/11 and 1/15 into the next Super Duo and down your 4mm. Pick up your last 15 here and then back up your bicone. I'm going to go to the back now because that's just the easiest way to go. And this is what we have so far. Right, so now we need to put the bail on. And what we need to do that, we need to be at this top bicone. So we've got to work our way up there. Because of this embellishment at the front, it's possibly better to go through the back. Or not, we've just got to go where it lets us go. So I've come out the front, so I'm going to go back up through these three beads, I think. And then through the next Super Duo, just the Super Duo, not the bicone. So we're back at the other side of this Super Duo, and I'm going to go back up these three beads here. There's no point in having thread showing when you don't need it. If you're happy just to step up, that's fine, don't go around these, but I'm going to go around them. So I've made my way up to this bicone now. So I'm going to pick up 5 11 aught seed beads. I'm coming out of this side of the bicone, so I'm going to go over and through the other side of the bicone to make a loop. And I'm going to make this into a little pico because I do like my picos. So we go back up the seed beads, up two, skip the middle one and back down two. Okay, see how that thread is over the 11 aught? We need to pop that thread the other side and then give it a gentle pull. And you see now it's gone underneath it and it's formed a little picot. So we go back through the bicone. And now we're going to go up three of these seed beads because I'm going to put a loop on the top now. And I'm going to pick up 7 15-aught seed beads. And again, I'm going to fold my loop. So I'm coming out of this side of the 11-aught, so I'm coming round to go through it again. And that's formed a loop there. So I'm going to go around these 2 or 3 times now, just to secure it. That's one. One more time. If you find it starting to get a bit tight, then it's probably best you don't do too many. But if you're happy going round and round, then go round and round. So that's all I'm going to do now, but I need to come out of the 11 on the top of the picot because I need to work my way back down. So I'm coming out of the 11 on this side. It's a bit hard to see at the moment with this loop. Then I need to go back down 2 and back into the biker and the back through the super duo, because I'm going to make my way back down here so I can start to tie off. So I need to go back through these 3 seed beads on the outside because I want to follow my path, and then it goes into the my super duos again. And like I said, this is going to be rather tight. So just be gentle, be patient, and I'm sure you'll get there. Through the last super duo, and now I'm going to go down this bicone before I tie my first knot. And I'm also going to try and go through the 15-aught seed bead as well. I'd rather have my knot going into the bicone than into the seed bead. So I'll go through the 15. Now I'm going to pick up my thread that is in between the 15 and the bicone. I'm going to hold it with my thumb and finger on the other side, and I will wrap my thread around 2 times. Put it down by my fingers, hold it, and then pull the needle and then let it feed in gently and slowly so you know where it's going, and then back up your bicone. I've gone up the bicone and I've gone through the first super duo, so I've just turned it over and you can see from the other side. Make sure you don't catch any thread anywhere. I'm going to go through the middle bicone again, middle super duo. And again, I'm going to work my way here to put another knot in here. Through the middle one. Through the third one. Down the bicone. Through the 15. And that's where I'm going to place my knots. So pick up the thread that's on the 15 and the bicone, hold it again with your thumb and finger. If you want to do, you know, the traditional half inch knot, please go ahead if that's what you're happy with. This is exactly the same way, I just do it differently. I've done it since I was little, so I know how it works and I'm happy with it. So pull it gently to watch where your knot goes and then work your thread away from your knot. That's all the knots I'm going to do on this, just to show you, but if you're happy to keep going round and keep knotting, then please do. The more knots the better. So I'm just going to work my thread away. I know that's tight in there. I'm just going to try and get through to the other side of that and then cut my thread. Because hopefully the tightness of the beads will hold the thread. It's actually gone down the 4mm. That's fine by me. I'll cut it off there. Like I say, if you're happy to keep going round and tie more knots, please do. Right, you may notice that this bill at the top isn't very round, so we'll just stick something in it. The beading bradawl's good for this. I just haven't got mine to hand at the moment, so. In fact, a beading bradawl is probably a lot better than this, or something round. Try that. Right, and now I'm going to put my bail on. So I'm just using this simple little bail. It's silver, so it matches my silver beads. Just pop it in. Squeeze it shut, and there you have it. All you need to do now is pop on a chain or a piece of leather and you've got your very own pendant. My name is Mo Neeson, I'm of Easy Beady. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you found this tutorial fun and useful, if not challenging. You can find me on Facebook, just look for Easy Beady. I would appreciate a like on there, it would be lovely. And I'd also love to see pictures of your results from any of my tutorials on there. It would be lovely to see them. Thanks very much. See you next time. Bye.